The letter signed by the Secretary to the State Government, Barrister Sarodion Oge, requested an expeditious screening and confirmation of the nominee. In his application, the House Leader, Roland Asoro, said the Commissioner nominee, having met with the committee, proved to be competent and a loyal party man who deserves the appointment. Addressing members consequent on his invitation to the hallowed chambers, the Commissioner nominee, Engineer Uyi Edebe, intimated them of his educational qualifications, expressing his readiness to serve the state in any capacity, but however, did not brief the House on his work experience and membership of the APC.
I'm giving the opportunity and want to partner with the state government to see how best we can drive his developmental strides, his initiative in taking Edo State to the next level.
The issue raised by the Commissioner-designate generated a minor argument among members. After interacting with the Commissioner-designate, the House Leader, Roland Asoro, and his deputy, Marcus Onobun, applied for his confirmation.
I am sure that it is the position he's been able to convince honorable members that he has something to offer to the people of Edo State.
Concluding proceedings, the Speaker, Mr. Francis Okie, pronounced Engineer Uyi Edebe as a civil commissioner in the state, while urging him not to be confined by his discipline, but open up his mind to contribute to the development of Edo State.
Mr. Richard Uyi Edebe is hereby confirmed as a civil commissioner in the Edo State Executive Council. Clerk, take appropriate steps to express the House position to the Executive Government.
The Speaker, during plenary, also urged the Committee on Rules and Business to slate for publication a bill for a law to provide for the establishment of Edo State Sports Commission. The Speaker also informed the House of a petition asking it to intervene and initiate a probe to compel the Malaysian authorities to probe the death of an indigene of Edo State and a PhD candidate, Mr. Thomas Ewansia, who died in custody of Malaysian authorities. The Speaker referred the petition to the House Standing Committee on Security with a 2-week timeline to submit it report for consideration. Meanwhile, the House Ad Hoc Committee, looking into claims by some members who alleged that they were inaugurated under duress, chaired by the Chief Whip, Henry Okwarobo, said its assignment was ongoing just as they are awaiting response of the lawmakers. The Speaker, Mr. Francis Okie, approved additional 2 weeks to enable the committee conclude its assignment. Sitting continues. Kingsley Uchebu reporting.